Hey guys, quick video time. If you're watching this now, I'm no longer live. I'm just gonna do a quick tutorial of how to use micas with epoxy on a tumbler. And this is gonna apply too for like resin artists and all that too. But this will give you guys a good idea of, hey Angela, of how much mica to use, because I've gotten tons and tons of questions over the last couple days. Hey Betty, of how to apply it, how to add it to epoxy, how much to use. So I just want to get all that covered. Okay, I totally understand, Betty. Hi Amanda. So I'm hoping all the ladies that have been asking questions, watch this video and it completely helps you out. So just got this all mixing up, make sure it's all good. And I hope you guys can't see the background. My shop is tore up because I pretty much moved two shops into one, so now everything's cluttered. And I'm putting it in its nice little happy home, but I'm making a mess doing it. Okay, so, got that. Let's see, don't knock stuff down. I'm gonna take this off for a second so you guys can see. Okay, so I got my cup. There we go. And again, excuse the epoxy table. Oh my gosh, George, you're gonna give me a complex. Hey, Kelly. Okay, I'm trying to move everything. There we go. So you guys can see. So I just have little medicine cups with my epoxy. I'm gonna just put a little bit in each one. I've got leftover in here for the quick coat. Oh, hey Cindy. I was hoping when you first said I can't hear, I was like, oh God, what am I doing wrong now? Okay, so I chose three colors. I took a little bit of inspiration from Jessica's cup. So I'm gonna use colors like that. Mine will definitely not be as gorgeous as hers, but I'm gonna take some inspiration. Okay, so with my micas, they're very potent. Like they add color really well. So the little spoons I include, this is half the size of it. And it's even, it's not like bulky or anything like that. So this spoon size would be considered 1/4. So if you need exact measurements, start off with 1/8 teaspoon and add it to your epoxy. And honestly, I don't even think I need this much since I chose to do a smaller cup. I don't have that much epoxy mixed up. So I'm gonna just get, so that's what's, I still got some on there. I'm gonna put that in there, mix it, make sure it's bright enough. Cause with these, like you wanna start off little, but that looks gorgeous. Super bright. So I like that. I don't think I need to add any more of that color. Hi, Jen. Oh, this one is sea glass. I should say what they are, huh? Okay, now I'm gonna get some Devil's Bay, another kind of blue. See that? That's about 1/4 of the sample spoon size. Hi, Sandra. Then yeah, definitely watch so this gives you a good idea. And again, start off with that 1/4 of a sample spoon size, 1/8 of a teaspoon. We just want to make sure we don't see anything if it's like that perfect color that you want. That's really pretty. I'm gonna add a tiny bit more to show you guys. Okay. So there we go, there's about 1/4. It still honestly looks about the same because it colored it so well the first time. Going to cover our cup nicely. Hey, Denise. Okay, I hope this does help some of you guys too. What do I do with my little towel? All right, and now what do I have? Icy blue. This is a white, but it has an iridescent blue to it. So that's 1/2 a sample spoon size. And I'm just gonna use this. And like I said before, the micas mix really well into epoxy with the pigments. You have to mix a little bit longer. Okay, this course isn't gonna work out how I, but I hope you guys can see that blue sheen to it. It's a really pretty. Hi, Carol. It's icy blue, Jen. All right. So hopefully that helped you guys a little bit. Hi, Lisa. To show you how little you use. So 1/2 a sample spoon size, or if you need to be OCD, I completely understand. Get 1/4 teaspoon. I mean 1/8 teaspoon. And you can use it and measure that out proper. Yes. Okay, let me put this back over here. Linda, try not to drop the phone. And I look like a hot mess. Because I've been spilling micas all over myself today. Okay, get that on there. You know what? See, I'm really bad, Lisa, because I never measure my epoxy. I am really bad. I know this does say this is 10, but you can, seriously, it could be 20, and it's still going to be just as bright. Hey, Susanna. So, Lisa, it doesn't matter how much mLs of epoxy you start with. Still start with 1/8 teaspoon or 1/2 a sample spoon size of micas. And that should honestly cover it just fine. I hope that makes sense. Get all these out of the way. Okay, so I still have that clear left over, and I am just gonna put a clear coat on here so that way when I do put the ones with micas, it'll just be a lot smoother and like start doing its own thing. Oh, you know what else helps? If I plug this in. I'm so sorry, you guys. I'm such a hot mess. So yeah, and plug in your turner. Okay. So I got my glove on. Safety first. Give this a nice thin coat. And I don't tape mine, but that's definitely preference for everyone. And I just hit it with a heat gun, that way it's moving along faster. It's a little bit cold in my shop right now. Okay, good. I'm glad to hear that, Susan. I guesstimate a lot, but this one I want to kind of try to be precise, at least with how much mica to add. Okay, so I got a good coat on there. And also before you guys, I don't think I told you this, but I sanded my cup super well. No matter what kind of material you use, alcohol inks, the micas, whatever else you use for tumblers, you always want to give your cup a really good sanding so that way the epoxy adheres to it better. Okay, so I want, since I still have a lot of clear, I'm going to mix it. I'm going to put a little bit more in here, and it's not going to affect the color at all. I'm not going to need to add more blue. So that's what I mean by it's still these micas are still going to be really bright. If I get closer, see, it's just as bright as it was. Oh, I shouldn't have took my glove off. I think I want the cup to be majority of this color. So I'm just gonna smooth that out. Turner's being a little bit loud right now. There we go. Make sure I get it a little bit of everywhere. Hit it with my heat gun. I can see where my cup has a problem right here. It's not like fully sealed right there. So I'm gonna try to stick some epoxy in that little crack. I glanced at it and thought it would be a problem and then kind of forgot about it and started the video. All right. George, you'll just have to send me a message. I never list them. I usually just have fun and make them. Okay, our Devil's Bay. Focus. Okay, won't focus. Do a little bit of that beach thing Jessica had on, going on. Her cup was gorgeous, you guys. All your cups. See, it's kind of doing its own thing. It was. I'm going to hit a little bit of that white, the icy blue down here. I can tap it. Laura, I think I'll just tap it. And if I get a little right here, I just wipe it. But yeah, it stays good up there. Doesn't want to go that way. Okay. Now, I'm sure you guys will be way more creative than I am. But since I had nothing planned out, I just wanted to use those colors she used. So, look at how pretty the micas are and how little you add and how to do it. Don't judge how the cup looks because I'm not doing the best job right now. But I still love doing it. It's so relaxing. Yes, that too. Make sure your turner is level. Honestly, I prefer to use the footballs, the Nerf balls. And I think Betty, I thought I heard her say something like in her group, Tumbler Talk, that someone was teaching how to make the things that you plug into there. And then attach it. And I thought, oh, that's cool. I need to go back through and find that and see how to make those. So you guys, you know, I just don't want you to be scared to use them. Look how easy this is. It's doing its own thing and it's happy about it. So don't be scared to try the micas, and a little bit goes such a long way, so it's not like you're wasting. If you feel like something is a fail, you didn't waste, you know, anything. I've got two fish eyes right there. Hopefully those get on. And so I'm gonna hit it with the heat gun and show you guys something. So on low, real quick. Okay, so I'm getting rid of my air bubbles that way. I'm gonna get up here a little bit more. Oh, back to the question about up here too. I feel like also if I can't get it to stick well enough, I'll wait 15 minutes after I'm done applying. In 15 minutes, I'll come back through and for some reason it wants to stick better too. Just gonna do it that way, see what happens. I thought I had gold glitter. Hi, Jamie. I just have my little glitter spritzer. I think this is Miami Nights in there. I can't remember which one it is, but I'm just gonna hit it down at the bottom. Yeah, you do get a pretty swirl. And I'm sorry if I'm missing questions. So, we'll go that way now. Since this is just a fun cup to show you guys, I just want to show you. You're just gonna get a cool swirl effect this way too. Let that go around, do its own thing. So these colors that I just went this way are already starting to do like little waves. And that would be awesome for a beach cup too. So hopefully, can you guys see how it's changing up on its own? Just from turning? Now I'm gonna hit it with a heat gun on high and show you what that does. It's gonna move it around a lot. See, by hitting it that high, all the epoxy is dripping off. But see how it's completely kind of changed the look of it, too? It's blending more and moving around more. And there's that darn fisheye. Jamie, your office looks good. I saw a picture. You're almost there, girl. He'll be back up and going in no time. It's hard moving to a new house. But I saw the pictures of your backyard and I have to say I'm jealous. It's so pretty. I want that much grass in my backyard. Guys, there is one gnat right here, and it's driving me insane. What do you guys think? Is that easy enough to use micas? Nothing to be scared about? Give them a try, you guys. This will be my wave part. Oh no. Oh, sick babies are the worst. It's so sad. You just want to help them. Focus. It's not focusing very well. Go back with it. Well, that looks better. I'm going to hit it with a little bit more of that glitter. I don't know what color this is, but I'm going to poof it on. This is Mica, and I think it's Purple Ghost. So it's white and it has a purple sheen to it. And I have one more spritzer over here that has blue glitter. Since this is just a fun cup, I'm gonna hit it with everything that's within my arm's reach. Lisa, it's a glitter spritzer. Or Mica. You can put Mica in there too. So this one has Mica. See if I can. There we go. Hopefully, you guys can see that coming out. I'll hit that spot really good so when it comes around, you should be able to see it. See right there where I hit it? Did you like the spritzers? Okay, get this on low again. Get rid of those, any air bubbles left. Okay, I don't see any more popping. Yeah, you guys, what do you think? Oh, they still haven't gotten there? Here, I think sometimes it helps if I flip the camera. What do you guys think? Think about all the different directions I went and how micas are just gonna do their own thing. But honestly, for throwing everything on this cup, I think it's gorgeous. This will be a happy cup. So hopefully, all you guys that were asking how to use some micas won't be scared anymore. I want you guys to try it. Okay, you guys, try to give them a try. Post pictures. You'll fall in love with it. See, isn't that cool? I might grab some black. I have black close to me. I think I want to put a little black on there. Or some chameleon. Maybe I'll do some chameleon. Since it's a free-for-all cup. Hey, Sarah. And that can be my sand. And the tide's coming in, so the sand's everywhere. The tappa-tappa-tappa method. Jen, this is a new one. It's a new chameleon. It's got gold with red and a tiny bit of purple. That'll be coming out very, very soon. Flip it again so you guys can see one more time. See? No one be afraid. Look at that. Through the whole kitchen sink on that one. Yeah, see it's gold, and then when it's going down, it's going red. All right, you guys, I really hope this helped some of you. Always send questions to Jen. There's so much goodies right behind me. That's another reason why I'm a hot mess right now. These goodies are going to be so fun. I can't wait to share them. Alrighty, guys. So hit me with all the questions you want. Just, you can PM me or write on here, and you know I'll try to get back to you whenever Facebook lets me see it, apparently, because it just shows me certain things these days. But I'm going to try my best. Thanks, girly. Alrighty, guys. Well, I hope you all have an amazing night. And I'll do another live very soon. Alrighty. Bye, guys.